Here we go, I'm TJ Quake, the ghetto gamer on this gaming thing.
I'm back with some real, true information. Information that's sweet, and it was brought to me by a new follower here on the channel that kind of made a comment on my last review or my last little commentation on the whole Snow White scenario. Oh, that's right. Today is about the real Snow White, the one, the iconic, the almighty only ever was. True iconic voice is what I'm talking about. The voice, the tone that only this woman was able to sweetly deliver. So we're gonna talk about that today on TJ Quake's Ghetto Gaming Pop Culture Talk. Welcome everybody. Let's get ready to do this bad boy. You know how I do. Okay. Now, once again, I have to say this. I love it when I have people that like to come in and make comments. Whether it's negative, whether you agree with me or you disagree with me, I'm all good with it, ladies and gentlemen. I love it when people come in and give their points. What's their argument about someone? What do they think should have been done? How they feel about the situation? That's what it's all about, baby. People, it's about communication and being able to talk to one another like human beings should be able to do. Unlike what's happening in society today with a lot of Democrats who like to yell, shout, scream, and start throwing bike locks at you. Yeah. So this person here, I'd like to thank. I believe it's a female, Leah Michelle Fan, 2244. This person here enlightened me to who the actual actress was who did Snow White and everything. I believe and we're going to get into that right now, because that actual actress that actually played Snow White, I have right her, and we're going to get right here. Let's go ahead and show this girl's face right now. There is Adriana Caselotti. I believe it's Caselotti or something like that. I believe Caselotte or Caselotti, something like that. I'm not sure if I'm getting there. If I'm getting the last name wrong, please correct me and everything. But this was the actual actress, okay? The actual the woman who portrayed Snow White in the original 1937 Snow White movie animation, okay? And ladies and gentlemen, This girl here laid the foundations for iconic voicing of animated characters, and kind of from her point on, that's the way animation cartoons for Disney was for a long time. She kind of benchmarked that vibe of vocal talent, as you will, and a lot of these type of animated type things that, you know, happen. She's actually the woman who plays in none other than the Good Witch in the Wizard of Oz. Yes, that's her. Adriana Caselotti, and I'll show you a picture of that too, just so you can see her iconic role, as everybody knows who she was. She was the Good Witch in The Wizard of Oz.
Are you a good witch or a bad witch?
Who, me? I'm not a witch at all. I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas.
Oh, well, is that the witch?
There you have it. There she is, right there. The Good Witch and the Wizard of Oz and so forth. So yes, ladies and gentlemen, we got all kinds of things with this girl. This lady has achieved in her life. And I think these type of things need to be shown to people, to bring people back to the reality of who actually started this, who were the pioneers for this, and the people that brought a type of fantasy world for children to be able to kind of live in and get away from the real world, the craziness in the real world that we deal with today. Yes, today's craziness is polluted by people like Disney today. Not Walt Disney from the real Walt Disney. Walt Disney would be rolling in his grave if he saw what Rachel Zegler and what the supposed people that are running Disney now, like Bob Iger and the rest of these flip necks that want to freaking push perverted flavor down children's, you know, throats. You know, he want to put this on kids all day long. Oh, we want to put all these things dealing with sexuality and them's theirs and LGBTQ and all that other kind of craziness. Yeah, we want to put that in the Bibbidi Bop store for your little girl to come by, and there's a man with a beard in a dress coming up to your girl and saying, come on in, little girl, and come on into the Bibbidi Bop store here at Disneyland. And I think parents are like, oh yeah, come on here, Sally, let's go. Oh, something's going on over here. It's like, come on. No, we don't want that, ladies and gentlemen. We want the real deal. We want this right here. We want the situation where what we had back in the day when we were children. That's what people want. People, you have some people. I had some people coming on, you know, saying, "Oh, what are you guys doing? Why are you guys all crying and boo-hoo? And you guys grown adults." Talking about all this stuff about the way this is put for kids, and you guys are crying about a chick playing Snow White. Come on, guys, get real. Listen, buddy, we all used to be children, and we grew up with this. See, what people need to understand, the reason why everybody's tripping about what Disney's doing to these classics, I tell you. Well, the reason why they're having a problem with it is because this was our childhood. We grew up with these animation cartoons as kids, and we want to be able to put this in front of our children today, our little ones today. We want them to have the same experiences we had when we were children, when we were innocent, before the chaos and demonic evil of the world we had to come and actually realize that we live in. And now we got to deal with all this craziness. Kids don't have to deal with that. Kids get an opportunity. That's the reason why we don't want this stuff pushed down on children, because children are innocent, and we want them to have the time to be able to have playtime, to be a child, to be, you know, carefree and enjoy being just a kid. You know what I'm saying? That's what it was about. Is that now kids' innocence is being torn away from them. They're trying to push all this craziness about, oh, the kids can go ahead and change their sex and all this other crazy, stupid stuff. You know what I'm saying? And it's wild and crazy. And it's people like Rachel Zegler who comes out here and destroys stuff like that, but with the comments she says. Now we're gonna I digress here. So let's go back to what we're really originally here for. Adriana, this iconic lady right here, who made it happen back in her day, and let's give you guys just a little insight on her and everything and what she was about. I'll bring that up right here. Adriana Caselotti. Caselotti took on the iconic role when she was just 18 years old, ladies and gentlemen. She was only 18. But technically, at the time, and it's very strange, I'm going to let you guys see a little bit of snippet of interview with her back in, I think it was in 1991 or something like that. She did this interview. She actually lived all the way up to like 1997 and everything. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, she died from cancer. So, unfortunate thing about that. She lived a pretty great life and everything. She starred in a number of little other things too, but obviously The Wizard of Oz being another major hit. Disney released its first full-length animated feature film with Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. Not the seven hippies. Not the seven, you better pronounce our pronouns correctly. No, not the seven woke flipnecks. No, the Seven Dwarves. See, back then they had a problem saying it. That's what the whole movie was about. It was about Snow White and seven little guys called dwarves. It was basically come from like a medieval Dungeons and Dragons period. Okay? And in Dungeons and Dragons, there's dwarves in Dungeons and Dragons. You know, there's halflings, there's hobbits. These are the names of some of these, you know, mystical people in these Dungeons and Dragon medieval lore, I guess. Okay. The movie was huge hit. And this is also during the time that we had major inflation going on in the country. It was the It was a very bad period in time. People were homeless, didn't have jobs. It was the Great Depression, ladies and gentlemen. It was very hard. And this was movies was the things that got people out of that stigma of being, you know, we having to deal with all these hard times. It was a release factor to get away from the real world and go into a fantasy world. And people like this woman here, Adriana, who came out there as a little girl and decided, I want to play this part and everything, and because I believe I have the skills that they're looking for, the talent, the voice that they're looking for, because she did. She had her own iconic little sounding voice, and you're about to hear just a little bit. I'm gonna give you a little bit of Adriana here, but this is one of the pictures of her and everything. We got many others here of Adriana, and I'm going to show you some really cool stuff. Once again, I want to give a shout out to Leia Michelle Fan, Michelle Fan 2020-2244 for bringing my attention to this. And this is what I want people to start doing. You guys, come on here, give me some comments. Let me know what you think. Enlighten me. This person here enlightened me to who the actual actress was. And I said, dude, that's actually a good idea. She told me basically, hey, why don't you do a video on the actual actress, the real Snow White and everything. Forget about this Rachel Zegler fake wannabe who, you know, can't even appreciate the fact that somebody still let her play Snow White when she ain't white. Everything, you know what I'm saying? They still let her play the role. And at least if she would have been somewhat cool and tried to be true to Snow White, then, you know, like what was one of the things she said in one of her text things to people, said, I hope you guys don't think I'm not going to be bleaching my skin because, you know, she's Latina, okay? And you know, of course, she's brown. So, yeah. The whole idea is that, you know, no, we're going to put a brown skin person and they're going to play Snow White and y'all going to like it. And she puts it in your face like that. And she wants you to know that we're changing everything. We're changing the love story. We're changing the way the prince comes into the picture. We might not even have a prince and so forth. We're going to do everything different because I'm a girl boss and we're going to bring this movie to this time period. Do you think that the women at that time in 1937 thought that, oh, we want to have our roles to be of the women of today? Well, no, she was playing a part, playing a role of a female that lived back in, like, say, the 1500s, 1300s or something like that, medieval period time when there was knights and all that kind of stuff going on. That was the time period they were playing in. So, no, you got to play to the time period, dumb flip, so forth. But anyway, we got Adriana in an interview here that I'm going to show you guys, where she kind of gives you a little insight on her flow. Let's go to that right now real quick so you guys can check that out. I don't want to make the video too long, but you're going to see a couple little things that I just want to show you.
Father was a singing teacher here in Los Angeles, and one day one of the Walt Disney representatives called his studio and asked if he knew of a little girl who could sing and speak like a child. And I was listening in on the extension phone upstairs, and I said, Papa, how about me?
Walt Disney was not in the room to hear my audition. What I found out later was that he was behind a screen in the same room but in the back.
So, ladies and gentlemen, as you guys can see, this was the real Snow White and everything. And you guys got to see some of the stuff, some of the work they did with her. She was actually 18. They wanted somebody that was 14, 16, around that range. And she kind of fibbed and told that she was actually that she was 16 so that she could at least get the audition. And of course, it worked out because she was overall the one that they wanted and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? This is what happened, ladies and gentlemen. But and granted, she didn't even really get credit for the role that she took for playing Snow White at first. Yeah, they didn't really give her credit and so forth, which I thought was kind of, you know, odd. Why not give the credit to the real person? But she went on many years later, from that time period on, playing Snow White, going to little kid functions and dressing up as Snow White and whatnot. You got to see her do a number of little things for children and whatnot. Here's a little thing right here of her actually playing doing the actual, you know, role of Snow White, kind of getting into the mix of the vibe, kind of, you know, it was kind of like a play along to the actual cartoon and so forth. This is her right here, and I'll show you that right now. Right here. Check it out, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, I'm bringing the flow for you, Michelle.
Who swept this room? You think their mother would... Maybe they have no mother. Then they're orphans. That's too bad. I know. We'll clean the house and surprise them.
You know, I can still sound like Snow White, but I'm a little afraid that I don't look much like her anymore.
That's all right.
Ladies and gentlemen. So that was just a little bit of her. And that's her older, much older right there. She still sings like her. Still has that iconic voice. She can still sound like the way she sounded when she was 18 and whatnot. But, ladies and gentlemen, you got to give credit where credit's due. I give credit to where credit's due. And if you want to do a remake of Snow White, that's fine. But at least make it the way everybody remembered Snow White as. Don't try to change it up to, we're going to make it today's period. We're going to do it the way women should be today because, you know, that man that was in love with her, oh my gosh, sticky, icky. No, he was a stalker and so forth. Somebody made a comment on here talking about the Rachel Zegler is playing the wrong role. She should have been playing the witch. Yeah, the evil queen. And I 100% agree. I'm telling you. She is literally that, but she portrays more of the witch. Godot should have been Snow White. You know what I'm saying? Godot has the face and the look of Snow White. And Rachel should have been the damn witch. Because that's what her real personality is. Her real personality is a witch. Because she's very mean-spirited type of person. The things she said online about, you know, certain people online, certain other actors out there that she talks shiz on, you know. Because she's such a freaking, you know, I revolt against the system. You know, I'm a woke, you know, activist. I'm going to speak my mind on Twitter, and I'm going to say all kinds of stuff about all kinds of people and everything that she don't even know. The girl just literally got into the dadgum industry, and already she thinks her head's got so big that she thinks she can just talk smack on all these actors out there that have made it and been around long before she was even a thought and so forth. And she thinks she's got the right. Well, I'm here with the big boys now. So yeah, I'm one of the big boys. I can do what the big boys do. And I think I got the clout to say stuff now. No, you don't. And everything. Learn your place, girl. You need to earn rank first. You got to get them ranks. You got to put them badges on and so forth before you can start opening your mouth thinking you one of the elites. You ain't one of the elites yet. You're about to lose your career. And we need more people like this. Like what I was saying is somebody like this should have been the person that played Snow White. We should have found somebody that had this kind of vibe. Somebody that would actually portray Snow White in the way she was portrayed in the cartoon. That would be more iconic to me. That would be more realistic. That would be more freaking exciting to see somebody actually come out and they get a girl who actually sounded like the way Snow White sounded. Listen to the way Snow White sounds right in this real quick. And everything. She's playing along. She's gonna sing along to one of the lyrics of the song. Listen to this that she did back in the day.
When I first saw the picture, tell me, how did Snow White sing?
Well, she sang like this.
We are standing by her wishing well. Make a wish into the well. That's all you have to do. And if you hear it echoing, your wish will soon come true.
Ladies and gentlemen, she still sounds like she did back in the day. That's amazing. And so forth. Could they have found somebody that probably could have used that kind of voice tone in a real live action movie? That would be unique. That would be more talented. That would be more like, wow, this girl actually sounds like the person did in the original 1937 version. That's exciting to people. That's what people want to see. If you're going to do a live action version of this, try to cop the actual way it was done in the cartoon. That brings more of excitement. That's what I would be looking at. Like, ooh, I like what they did this. If you want to add a couple little knickknacks, you know, put a little more spice in it, you know, and so forth. Cool. That's cool. Nobody's wrong. Have a problem with that and so forth. But as you can see, she's sitting by the wishing well, Rachel, and what she was singing about is wishing for true love. That's what she was about. She was wishing for true love. And your dumb behind runs and say, oh, we're not going to have a love story. No, we're going to take a love story out. Because that's 1937. That's old school. Nobody wants to do that. Women don't want to fall in love anymore. So that's the problem with people today. That's the reason why we got all these divorces happening every day, ladies and gentlemen. There's no family values anymore. Back then, they had family values. There was the nuclear family, which is what the Democrats are trying to destroy today. They're trying to get rid of the nuclear family. They want you all to depend on them. Don't have a man in the house. Don't have no stability around. Count on us and keep voting for us. We'll give you guys crumbs. And that's what they do. And so forth. And so these dummies like Rachel Zegler and everything, they don't get that part of it because they're these new millennials and Gen Z mother flips, you know. And I'm not saying all of them are, because we got some smart ones out there. Like, actually, some of the Gen Zs are a lot smarter than the millennials and everything. But this generation of kids today, they just done cuckoo got lost it for Cocoa Puffs. I mean, it's just ridiculous. And so forth. We can't get no real shiz anymore. No real authentic material, stuff that actually brings people to the movie theaters getting to go, man, I like the way the story was. That's what's going to grab people. These animation cartoons were part of a childhood that most of us all enjoyed. And that I would love to share with my child, and I want her child to be able to share with her kids and so forth. This was a generation thing that leaped over time and so forth. From 1937 all the way up to today, this is still the most classic animated cartoon out there. And it's what put Disney on the map and everything. Getting people like this to play roles and give a cool little animated fantasy world to children. And that's what it's all about. When Disney was supposed to be about children. And now they're about the LGBTQ and pushing sex on children. That's what they're doing now and so forth. And people are like, whoa, hey, oh, hey, oh, hey, it's good. What do you mean you want to put that on a little boy doing another little boy? What? That's going to be in the cartoon now? Oh, wait. Is you crazy? It's like, come on, man. When I was a little kid, man, these were things that we enjoyed being in a little fantasy world, and we weren't introduced to sexual immorality. That wasn't put in on children, everything. That was a no-no. You didn't deal with that stuff. That was adult stuff. That's why they put ratings on these movies, ladies and gentlemen. PG, G-rated. These were G-rated movies, and everything. They weren't rated R. You know what I'm saying? That was what Disney was supposed to be about. You know, but they ruined everything they touched. They ruined what George Lucas did. They ruined what Disney did. Disney wasn't about this stuff. Walt Disney wasn't about that. He was about real entertainment for children and so forth. And adults could enjoy it too because it had some adult, reality in it and so forth. And adults enjoyed it too along with their kids. It was an enjoyment for everybody. And so forth. And so that's what Disneyland was supposed to be. That's what Walt Disney created, was this fantasy world that people could go to and get away from reality of craziness for a little bit. And Disneyland, the people that own Disney now, have forgotten that. You notice that these leftists, when they get stuff, they destroy it and everything. When you got Kathleen Kennedy and Disney got freaking hold of George Lucas and stuff, they destroyed it. Nobody, the Disney Star Wars isn't Disney Star Wars to me. Or isn't Star Wars to me, I'm sorry. So I applaud actresses like Adriana Caselotti, who actually put their heart and soul into a movie. And the thing is, she didn't even realize that she was actually doing a live-action featured movie. She thought she was coming in for like a 20-minute, 30-minute like little session to do some little voices. And that's all she thought. She didn't know it until the movie came out. It was kind of crazy, the background story on some of this stuff. But that she's the one that, you know, made it happen. And I think they did a great job picking, you know, this woman here to play Snow White and whatnot. You know, there she is, some more other photos of her right there. You know, You know, you got these photos here of her. That, you know, does he, that that's a Snow White to me and everything. not Rachel Zegler. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. It's not a racist thing. It's just a cultural thing. It's a, you're playing a time period piece. If you're going to play a time period piece, play the part. Be the part that the time period piece is about. And yes, it was about a girl whose skin was white as snow. She was the fairest of them all. It was a fantasy story. Nothing more, ladies and gentlemen. You don't need to put in the whole racial tension shiz in there. It doesn't have to be all about race all the time, people. Everything. Play the roles. Put the people in to fit the role. If it's a role played by that was about a black person, you're going to put the black person in there, not a white person or a Chinese or a Latin person in there. You're going to put the black person in there to play the role. That's the way you would do it. Shaka Zulu's not going to be played by Tom Cruise. Everything. That would be absurd. And so forth. Just like we find this to be absurd. But no. We said, okay, whatever. We you're not going to put the dwarves in there. You're not going to put the person that actually looks like Snow White and everything. So I guess we'll just go ahead and try to go with it. And then what does this girl go off and do? Rachel Zegler, who said that the story was scary to her. Oh, I was frightened over Snow White. Did that scene that I just showed you, her singing in the wishing well, look like it was scary? Then she just doesn't get it. And that's the problem with people like that. They just don't get it. But I'll give you guys one little last piece right here.
I'm wishing for the one I love to find me today.
See, I'm wishing for the fine one to find me today. Sorry, my vocals are not like Adriana, but y'all know what I'm trying to do. Woo! Anyways, you guys, I thought I'd just bring this little piece of you guys, this little piece about the actual woman who played Snow White. And give you a little bit of the background on her and so forth. And you guys can look her up yourselves if you guys want to. See, the good thing about what YouTubers, content creators do is, you know, we like to find the truth and bring the truth out. Not put out this fake bullshit that the media wants you guys to learn and they melt your mind. People, go outside the out of the media and research this stuff for yourself. Be a thinking person. Be a person like this Leah Michelle who brought this to my attention and bring up the real facts of who Snow White was and the person who played Snow White. And maybe we can find somebody that actually could play a role like a Snow White role that would do as much of a good job as this woman did. Rachel's not going to do a good job because she doesn't like Snow White. She never did. According to her and everything. And then she goes back and forth on her stories and lies about, oh, well, I loved it when my parents took me to Disneyland every summer and I loved the rides then. And then she goes in one interview and talks about, oh, the ride was scary. It was horrible. What kind of, like, when kids would want to do that? Oh, my gosh. Prince Charming was a stalker. Weird. Like, woman, go somewhere. Your career is over after this. I hope you know that, Rachel. Nobody wants to watch you again. Nobody's going to go see you in the Hunger Games because they know who you are now. See, your personality, the problem with actors, and I'm going to leave off with this one last thing. The problem with actors today and everything is they're not like the actors back in the day. See, back in the day, actors used to keep their business to themselves. Their politics pretty much was kept on a silent mode. You didn't know about their stuff and their business unless it leaked out. Or some, you know, TMZ magazine type vibe came out and put their shiz on front blast, right? You didn't know about the personal lives. You really didn't know about the stuff. So they were always remained a mystery. The one thing that my uncle told me back in the day when I started getting, when I first got into, because, you know, I'm in a band called Slapback. Well, I'm a rapper in a band that, you know, we did our thing and so forth. And we still play to this day. But the one thing he told me when I was a young buck and everything, he said, TJ, the one thing you never do after a show is just go out in front of the audience and start trying to, you know, get out there and play with all the girls and try to get in with the audience and so forth and do all that stuff and so forth. You always want to leave and remain a mystery. Go to the back room, your green room, whatever, and remain a mystery. If they happen to see you, that's the one chance they're like, oh, you know, always be cool to your fans. Always be cool to your fans and so forth. You never say, oh, I don't want to sign no honor. No, you be cool with your fans. Why? Because they're the ones that are paying your damn paycheck. They're the ones to pay for you to be up there and so forth. You ain't got no fans. You ain't got nothing and so forth. So people need to learn that. Rachel needs to learn that. But the one thing he told me, because he learned this when he used to play for Isaac Hayes. He was a bass player. It was my Uncle Derek. And he used to play for Isaac Hayes, and he was band playing. He was young. And right after the show, he made the mistake of some girls were up there in the front, and as Isaac and everybody were getting ready to get off the stage, he stayed and remained on the stage and was up there like trying to chit-chat with all the girls up on the front of the stage, like, yeah, 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 you know, trying to get up in there. And Isaac came over there, and he said, picked his behind up and pulled him away and dragged him back to the backstage. And Derek's like, hey, man, what gives? What gives? And he said, I want to tell you, there's one thing you need to learn in this business. Remain a mystery. Remain a mystique. Because that's what's going to keep bringing the fans back. They're always going to, they're never going to know too much about you. They'll know a little bit, but not too much. And because they don't know that much about you, they'll always remain loyal fans to you. Because they don't know your politics. They don't know your desire, all your wild desires, all that stuff. It remains, so they always want to find out more and more, and they can't always get enough. And that keeps them coming back. But if you just put all your cards out on the table, you ain't got no more cards left. And so forth. Now, everybody knows what you're about. They see what you are. And some of them are like, I don't really like that. I'm not going to go see this guy again because I don't like, you know, this thing about him or this thing about him or these politics. And when you start opening your mouth too much like that, they don't want to see you no more. And so forth. So you got to remain a mystery. So that was the one thing, the advice that I could give to most of these flip-neck actors out there. Keep your mouth shut when it comes to trying to be an activist. If you're an activist, you're not an actor. Be an actor. We don't need to know about your politics and so forth. When I'm on stage and everything, I'm not telling everybody about my politics. I'm not going out there, hey, Trump, Trump, Trump. I don't do that and everything. I remain the musician, and that's it. And so these people need to learn that. And if they could do that, they could probably keep their fan base. Disney, you could probably keep your fan base and you wouldn't be going broke like you guys are right now with your shares down at about 82.7 or whatever. Everything. Oh, yeah, they're losing their butts over there. The shareholders are like, what is over here? Disney's like looking horrible right now. They going, it ain't looking good for Disney, ladies and gentlemen. And Rachel Zegler and this new Disney movie, Snow White, if they don't put, they think that the releasing this movie is a good idea, these people are dead wrong. They're going to lose mega money. They think they lost money on all these other movies, like they lost more money on Indiana Jones. Wait till the Snow White movie comes out. This movie ain't no Snow White, and everybody knows it. Rachel pretty much spilt the beans. It's not about Snow White, the one that we knew by it, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Snow White she wants it to be. The way the Democrats and these leftists and these progressive idiots out there want it to be. Nobody believes in old school no more because they all think that that's racist and biased and not diversity. And so forth. If you want to make a power movie about a woman, then make an original movie about a woman who's empowered. And do it in a tasteful way. Where you don't have to put down the man to make the woman look good. And that's all I got to say, ladies and gentlemen. So anyways, ladies and gentlemen, this is once again TJ Quake, yo ghetto gamer. And once again, I want to thank Leia Michelle, 2223, out there to give me that little flavor. I love it when people give it. Put your comments in, people. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys like what you see here, please like, subscribe, and most definitely share the video. That helps us out and lets people know that we're out there for them and we're trying to make things happen. Y'all hearing me? Let's do it. I'm out. TJ Quake.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Here we go, I'm TJ Quake, the ghetto gamer on this gaming thing. Gonna bang them up, gonna shoot them up, right here on gaming strain. Bang, bang, blaze it on up, TJ Quake, we're busting like the one, two, three. Here we go. Let's get into this, y'all.
Yeah.
TJ Quake, the ghetto gaming show.